Hey everyone, welcome back to KT Sessions. If you are looking to automate tasks in Windows and add some customization to your workflows, then VBScript can be your new best friend. And don't worry, I'll keep it simple and beginner friendly. So let's get started. Power Automate Desktop is a tool that helps you automate repetitive tasks, but sometimes you might need extra logic or scripting to handle specific scenarios. That's where VBScript comes in. Let me show you how easy it is to use VBScript in Power Automate Desktop. Okay, so let me go to the flow. And when we go to this action palette and when we search for scripting, so we can see this group of actions of scripting. So it contains 6 actions and we are going to use this VBScript action, and in addition to this, we have JavaScript, .NET script, Python script, PowerShell script, and DOS command script. Okay, so we'll cover all these in upcoming videos, but today we are going to use the VBScript. Okay, so we can write the VBScript code whatever we want to execute. Okay, so for example, I'm writing some code wscript.echo hello. Okay, and it will produce two variable. One is VBScript output, and this variable will store the output of the VBScript, and another one is script error. So this will store the error. If there is any error during the execution of the VBScript code, then this script error will store that error description or error details. And wscript.echo, so this will assign the value hello value to the output variable, which is VBScript output. Okay, so let me rename this to script output. Okay, and let me click on save and let me run the flow. So now whatever message we are assigning to wscript.echo, it will assign that message to the script output, and that will become the output of our VBScript code. See, when we go to flow variables, we can see this variable script output, and in this the value is hello. Okay, so if you want to return anything from your VBScript, you can use this wscript.echo. okay, so let's see one more example. For example, if we have two variables in our VBScript, dimx, dimy, and we want to do the sum of these variables. Okay, so first I will initialize the value of this variable. X is 20 and Y is 30. And in output, I want to assign the sum of the X and Y. Okay, so I will write X plus Y. Now in this case, it will do the sum and it will assign the value to the script output. Okay, so we should get 50. So let me run the flow. And here we go, we are getting 50, and the script error is playing because we are not getting any error during the execution of the script. For example, if we divide x by y and y is 0, so now it should give some error. Okay, so let me run the script again. Let me run the flow, and this time we should get division by 0 error. See, we are getting some error, and we can see we have some value in the script error variable, but the script output is blank. Okay, so let me show you. You can see the details of the error in this. It is a runtime error, division by 0. Okay, similarly, whatever error message you if you're getting any error in your VBScript, so Microsoft Power Automate Desktop will save that error in the script error variable. Okay, so after running the script, you can check both the variables. You can add a if condition, means if script error is blank, that means your script has executed successfully, and if it is not blank, that means there was some error, so you can perform the further actions accordingly. Now, as of now, we are using variables of the VBScript only, but we can use the script our flow variables as well in our VBScript. So let me create one variable first. Now I'll show you how can we use the variables of the flow. Okay, so I'm creating one variable and I'm assigning the value 100 to this. Okay, let me assign a flow variable. Now when we go to the script and here we can use the variable, the flow variable, as we use the flow variable in other actions. Means just we need to, for example, instead of I want to use that flow variable. So I will delete the y and I will go to this select variable and I will select this flow variable. Or you can manually type the name. And we are not using this y anymore, so let me delete this. Okay, now we are dividing the x by the flow variable. So the value of the x is 200 and the value of the flow variable is 100. So we should get 2. Let me run the flow. And here we go, we are getting 2 in the script output. So this is how you can use the variable in the VBScript. Okay, so I have written this VBScript code and in this code we are using the word file. We have already posted a video on the word automation. So if you want to read or write the text from your word file, or if you want to insert any image in your word file, if you want to find and replace some text in your word file, so you can check out our previous video on word automation. And in this we have written some piece of code in VBScript, and with this code we are going to read the text of the word document. So let me show you the word document. This is the word document which we use in the previous video. So we are going to read all this text with the help of VBScript. However, we have actions to read this text, but we are using the VBScript. Okay, so in this we are using a variable which is file path. So let me create one variable file path, and in this file path I will give the path of that file. Okay, the file is available on my desktop, so I have given this path. Now this VBScript code will read this file, this Excel document, and it will save the result in the script output. Means it will read all the text and it will assign that text to the script output. Okay, so let me run the flow and here we go, we can see the script output and it contains the text of our Word document. So this is how we can use VBScript to perform any operation or any kind of process, which is for example, if I want to perform something and it is not possible in Power Automate desktop, means we don't have such action or built, so we don't have such built-in action to perform that activity. So what we can do is we can use the VBScript or any other scripting to make our job easier. Generally we use VBScript in our SAP application, so we can record the action of the SAP application, and that will create one script for us, and we can use that script in our flow. Just we need to execute that script to perform the actions on. I hope this tutorial helped you get started with VBScript in Power Automate desktop. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more tips and tricks on Power Automate desktop. See you in the next video. Happy automating.